You rub that hard hat on?
It feels about that long.
No, my kids are nervous. Shovels to designate the groundbreaking. The first new building of this type of stature at Pilgrim Pines was just 2 weeks short of 11 months ago. If we think of all that has happened in 11 months, the amount of snow that we had this winter, the enormous size of the hole that was dug. If you happen to see some of the pictures or happen to come on up and visit, it has been an amazing process. As people have expressed their thanks, I too express my thanks for your support, for the work we've done, for the prayers that have been offered, for the gifts that have been given. It's been exciting to see how God has worked through this process. And 11 months, at times it's gone real smooth, at times we've had some hurdles and some jumps. Not sure if you are aware of this, the fire chief came through last Tuesday at 10 o'clock for his final checkup. Eric mentioned we had campers who arrived at 3 o'clock on Wednesday. Our tables and chairs that you're sitting on, the kids will be in on, they arrived at about 9:35, the same time that fire chief showed up. The select board signed off on our certificate of occupancy at 6:30 on Tuesday night. We have Tilly, who's been in my office for the past 11 months. For those of you that have wondered, is there going to be eggs and bacon on the ceiling? Not on the ceiling yet, but it's on the wall back there. It will go up to one of the statues or the things that have been significant. We had the opportunity to remove some of the windows from the old building. We ripped up some of the floorboards. We have a number of different things that we want to decorate this building with. Right now we're in the building, and that's good. But we still have a ways to go to go ahead and get decorated on it. We're still working through a punch list. There are things, as you know, if you've done work on your home or constructing a church, there are things that need to happen to go through. And so we're still working through that. We'll continue to work that this summer around campers and things like that. One thing just to note, and because most of them you'll never see, if you walk around, I can tell you that we're missing one outlet. See if you can find where that outlet is. But one of the things that you might notice, we have this beautiful wainscoting that goes around the building. It just tries to bring in some of the outdoors, some of the atmosphere of the old, the natural sense of the old one. One of the things that has happened is that some of the humidity has caused the wainscoting to buckle in spaces. And so we're working with the architect, we're working with the installer to figure out how do we fix that problem. If you don't tell me, I know it's there. There's lots of sleep over how we're going to fix it. But we are going and working on that. One of the other things that's been talked about has been just the success, the financial success that this has allowed us to do, the millions of dollars that have been given. And people, as I talk with them, they come down and say, well, where are we? You know, are we done yet? Have we raised all the funds that have been necessary for this? I'll tell you that we have not. When our board decided to do a comprehensive campaign, where they said, let's look at what the cost of the building is, but we also need to raise money to have just our general operations. We negative fund our budget. We have a deficit budget each year, so that's covered by. Let's not try to separate, but let's roll things together to say, how much money does Pilgrim Pines need to raise over the next 3 years for this to be a success, so that people aren't needing to divide up. Well, here's my $25, I want to go to the campaign, I want to go through the operations. It's all together. We're close. Most building projects, they use a thermometer. We're at camp. Okay? The goal for this building and operation is $2.5 million. We have to date raised $2.1 million. Our canoe.
Thank you.
board and the campaign chair, the executive committee of the campaign, we set a goal of December 31st. We're in the building, we're using the building. We want to fill this canoe in and raise that last $400,000 in the next 6 months. Can we do it? I didn't think we'd get this far, where we started talking and dreaming and visioning a long time ago. If you attended one of the dinners, I asked a self-reflecting question, why are we doing this? In spite of the economy, why are we doing this? Because we trust in God, and God is faithful. We're going to move forward on that. I would invite you to pray with us for that process. The executive of the campaign chairs and the board, we put together a strategy that we're going to be implementing over the next few months. On how to reach that goal. It's not just going to happen by itself. But we're going to implement one of the things that we're going to be doing, is we haven't talked about it yet because we didn't know it was going to happen, but we are going to be instituting a brick walk. Many churches and schools and things, parks will do things as a way to raise money, but also to memorialize an individual or a family or something like that. So we will be, it's the first time we've talked about it publicly, but we will be doing having a brick walk around this building. You notice that we've got areas with not a whole lot of sidewalks for in and out. There's a loop or a path that's out in front of the building. There's exits coming out of the building. That we want to do that. On each of the different tables where the hors d'oeuvres are, there's a little form. One of the things that we also tried to do is to make this realistic and attainable for families. It's $100 per brick. If you want a big brick, then you get more money and you get more little bricks. We're in this together. Again, we want to try to get it before the 31st, but if that's something that you or your family are interested in, please, you can drop them off in the office of the meeting flower. In just a minute, I'm going to be inviting up Tad Trance. Tad is the president of McMillan, the company construction firm that oversaw the construction of this building, and he's going to be handing out some keys to different members, three sets of keys that will be going out. One of those sets of keys will go to Eric Edward, our Camp Squanto director, as he utilizes his building for the ministry. One set of keys will go to Mark Morin, who is a member of our board of directors, but also has been the chair of our facility task force for the past year. The third set will go to myself, representing the broader ministry of Pilgrim Pines. And when we receive these keys, they're symbolic. But they represent what God has done in our ministry. That Joe has talked about, that Dave has talked about, that our ministry has expanded. Our ministry is not 8 weeks of the summer anymore at Camp Council. Our ministry is now the potential of 52 weeks on this site for kids. And think of the lives that will be invited, the invitations that will be given. It's a dining hall, but it also has and serves the function of a meeting space, of a play space. And so at this point, I'd invite Tad to come on forward. I'm not sure where Tad is. In the back here, and Eric and Mark, these families as well, will receive our keys and take their building out. It's great to see everyone here. On behalf of the film company and all of our dedicated and hardworking subcontractors, it is my very great pleasure on this tremendous day to be the one standing here in front of you to be able to say, gentlemen,